In the previous lecture, we have solved a simple problem on in-plane eccentricity. In this lecture, we are going to solve another problem. A rectangular steel plate is welded as a cantilever to a vertical column and supports a single concentrated load P as shown in figure. Determine the weld size if the shear stress in the same is not to exceed 140 megapascal. Okay. So this is the given drawing. So here the welding is carried out like a C-section. So the outline of the weld is like a C-section and the load is acting on the same plane. Okay. So it comes under case 2 in-plane eccentricity. And we know that in in-plane eccentricity, the primary stress is shear stress and the secondary stress is also shear stress. Okay. So first you should understand the difference between case 1 and case 2. Here the welding and the load is acting on the same plane, that is why it comes under in-plane eccentricity. So the weight is given, the load acting is given and the shear stress of the weld region is given. We have to find out the size of the weld H. Okay. So we'll start from the primary stress. So the primary stress is shear stress, and we know that the shear stress, primary shear stress tau 1 is equal to P divided by A. And the equation for calculating area is 0.707 H into L. So L is the length of the weld, and here the length of the weld is 50 plus 100 plus 50. Okay, so it is 50 plus 100 plus 50. So you will get 141.4 H. So you can substitute the values in the stress equation. Tau 1 is equal to 16 to 10 power 3 divided by 141.4 H. So if you solve this equation, finally you will get tau 1 is equal to 424.3 divided by H Newton per mm square. So this is the primary stress. Now with considering the secondary stress, we have to calculate the secondary stress. So for calculating the secondary stress, we need to find out the equation for J. Okay, so this is the data book page number 11.5. So in the problem, we have a C weld outline. So this is the C weld outline. Okay, so this is the drawing we are going to use, and in this drawing the J equation is 2b plus d cube divided by 12. So there is a correction in the formula. You can verify that in your data book. It is 2b plus d the whole cube divided by 12. Then b square b plus d the whole square divided by 2b plus d. Okay. Then in the previous problem, the eccentricity value is directly given. So we have directly taken the eccentricity value from the drawing. But here the eccentricity value is not directly given. Okay. So actually the 150 mm is the distance between the load acting and the plate, the vertical column. Okay. But we have to locate the CG, that is center of gravity, to identify the eccentricity, because the eccentricity is the distance between center of gravity to the load acting. Okay. So that is the main point about this problem. Okay. So tau 2 is equal to T into R2 divided by J. Further, T is equal to P into E, that is load into eccentricity. And the eccentricity is equal to 150. So here I'm going to mark a point, that is G, that is center of gravity. And in the left side, it is X, that is X bar of the weld region, that is the center of gravity of the weld region. So we know how to calculate the center of gravity. This is X, and R1 is the distance between center of gravity to the plate end. Okay, so further E is equal to 150 plus R1. Okay, so that is the eccentricity. Now to find the value of R1, first we have to calculate the X value, because once if you calculate the value of X, so this is G, so this is R1 and this is X. So once if you calculate the value of X, we know the overall value is 50 mm. So once if we calculate X value, then further we can calculate the R1 value. So first we have to calculate the X value. Okay. So if you take the equation from the data book. In the data book, they have given the equation for x. So this is the x bar equation. So you can consider the C-section as three triangles, and you can go for calculation of x bar using ax1 plus ax2, or otherwise you can directly take the equation from the data book. Anyway, the equation is directly given in the data book. So this is the equation given in 11.5. x is equal to b square divided by 2b plus d. So here b is the weld length 50 and d is 100 mm, the plate width. So it is 50 square divided by 2 into 50 plus 100, that is equal to 12.5. Now the value of x is 12.5 and the overall length is 50. So we can calculate the R1 by subtracting the value of x from the 50. So it is 50 minus x, it is 50 minus 12.5, that is equal to 37.5. Now this value is 37.5, that is the R1 value, and we know that E is equal to 150 plus R1. So it is 150 plus 37.5, that is equal to 187.5. So here the eccentricity value we have calculated, it is 187.5. Remember that in the previous problem the eccentricity value is directly given, but here it is not directly given. That is why we have calculated the value of x, and from the x we have calculated R1, then from the R1 we have calculated the E value. Okay, so keep this in mind, it's very important. Now we have calculated the value of eccentricity, we can substitute it in the torque equation. So T is equal to P into E, that is 16 into 10 power 3 into 187.5, we will get 11.25 into 10 power 6. So it's like the previous problem. So now to calculate the value of R2, we have to construct a triangle. So we have already solved this kind of problems earlier. You can construct a triangle here, that is A, B and C. So here R2 is the hypotenuse value. So this is the R2 value, and the R1 value is same as the AB. So R2 is equal to root of adjacent side square plus opposite side square, that is AB square plus BC square. So here the AB value is the R1 value. So R1 value we have calculated, it is 37.5. Remember that it is not 50 by 2, because in the previous problem there is no transverse fillet weld. So we have calculated, parallel fillet welds were there. So we have used 50 divided by 2 because the center of gravity will be at the center. We know that if the section is symmetric about the y-axis, then the x-axis will be half of the distance. So that is why we have used 50 divided by 2 in the previous problem. But here it is not 50 divided by 2. The AB value is the R1 value. So it is R1 plus 50 square. So here the C section. So the C section is symmetric about the X axis. So Y bar will be equal. So this is symmetric about the X axis. So Y bar will be the overall length divided by 2. Okay. So here the Y bar length is 100. It is 100 divided by 2. That is why it is 50. So this weld region is symmetric about x axis, so y bar will be 100 divided by 2. It is not symmetric about x axis, that is why we have, y axis, that is why we have calculated the x bar value. So in some cases you may have a weld region like this, like a L section. So here you will not have symmetric about x axis and y axis. So in that case you have to calculate both the x and y. So here in the problem we have calculated only x. So if your weld region, because the C section is symmetric about the x axis, so that is why we don't need to calculate the y bar value, we can directly put divided by 2. But if you have a section like L section, then you have to calculate the x bar and y bar separately. Okay, so keep that in mind. So here I have calculated the value of R2. Okay, so the data is equal to tan inverse of BC by AC. Here BC is 100 divided by 2, that is 50, and the AB value is R1, that is 37.5. So theta is equal to 53.13 degree. For calculating the moment of inertia, The equation is 2b plus d the whole cube divided by 12 minus b square b plus d the whole square divided by 2b plus d, and don't forget to multiply 0.707h. Okay, so here the b value is 50 and the d value is 100. You can substitute it. D is 50, b is 50 and d is 100. Similarly, substitute all the values and you can calculate the j value, that is 275000h. So this is the polar moment of inertia value. Now we have calculated the t value, r2 value and j value. We can substitute it in the tau2 equation, that is tau2 is equal to t into r2 divided by j. T we have calculated, r2 we have calculated and j we have calculated. So you can substitute it. Finally, you will get tau2 is equal to 2557 divided by h. So now we have calculated tau1 and tau2. We can substitute it in the combined shear stress equation. That is tau max is equal to root of tau1 square plus tau2 square plus 2 tau1 tau2 cos theta. So substitute the value of tau1, tau2 and theta value and solve this equation. Bring h square outside, h outside. You will get 2832 divided by h, that is equal to 140. So 140 is given in the problem. Finally, h is equal to 20.3 mm. So the difference between previous problem and this one is, in the previous problem, the eccentricity value is directly given. Here it is not directly given. That is why we have calculated the R1 value. Okay. And also the C section is symmetric about the x-axis. That is why we haven't calculated the value of y. So if the section is not symmetric about y-axis, then we have to calculate the y value also for calculating the R2 value. Okay, so here eccentricity is 150 plus R1, then R1 is equal to the overall length, it is 50 minus x, that is x bar of the C section. So for calculating R2, it is AB square and BC square. Here AB is not 50 by 2 because this section is not symmetric about the y axis. So previously, in the previous problem, we have two parallel fillet welds. So these two parallel fillet welds are symmetric about both y axis and x axis. That is why we haven't calculated the x value and y value. We have simply divided by 2. But here it is different, that is why we have calculated, and theta, it is opposite side by adjacent side. I mean, then after calculating the R2 value, use the equation J, then don't forget to correct the equation in your data book. It is dB plus 2B plus D the whole cube divided by 12 minus B square B plus D the whole square, and don't forget to multiply 0.707. Then substitute everything and calculate tau2. So after calculating tau2, use the combined shear stress equation and calculate the tau max value and calculate the h value, that is size of the weld. So the tutorial problem is, a bracket as shown in figure carries a load of 40 kN. Calculate the size of the weld if the allowable shear stress is not to exceed 80 MPa. So the problem is almost like the previous problem. It is same. Okay. So here also the eccentricity is not directly given. So we have to calculate. So this C section, it is symmetric about X axis. So Y is directly equal to, Y is equal to 200 divided by 2. But it is not symmetric about Y axis. So you have to calculate the X value to find the value of R1. Okay. So first calculate tau1, then calculate tau2, then use tau1 and tau2 values in the tau max equation and calculate the value of h. So the value of h is equal to 7 mm.